What's up, everyone? I'm coming back on the old chopper build. You've been following along, I appreciate it. And I've been kind of off my game for a little while and haven't posted. I don't think I posted anything last week. So I'm back working on this thing here. So I wanted to jump back on it. So let me spin you around. And so here's where we're at right now. It's basically where I left off before. So we gotta get that out. So to do that, I've decided that I'm going to remove as much stuff off here as I can. So I am going to end up taking all this suspension off, and because I think my plan, I don't know if it's going to work. We'll find out. If this is part one of engine removal or just engine removal, then you'll know what happened. So I'm going to take this, I'm going to get everything undone, undo the engine mounts. The engine has to come out of this side of the frame, as you can see by the mount right there. And I'm just gonna take it and put this actually off the lift on the floor on its side and unhook the engine mount and see if I can just pick the frame up right off the engine. I heard people installing engines that way, so we'll see what happens. So let's get going. In for a little update. So I unhooked the back shocks. This is the swing arm pivot bolt that goes all the way through to hold the swing arm. So I got it off of this side, so then I pushed it through it, this whole plate, which is sitting right there. It came off the side in one piece. The brake switch is still here, so I'll need to get that out of the way at some point. But now I should be able to pull that pivot shaft the rest of the way out. Or whatever they call it pivot shaft on a Harley. I don't know if they call that on a Honda or not. Pull this the rest of the way out, which is coming pretty easy. Take this plate off, which is loose now, because it just comes off there. And then another way I have to figure out is the chain. You may have saw me spin the chain around in the time lapse. And I was doing that trying to see if I could find a master link to, like, which is a spot where you can kind of pop a little thing up and the chain will come apart. I didn't see one, so I think I'm gonna have to take this cover off to where the transmission sprocket is in there, this chain hooks to, and just feed it off manually and take it off. So I get back to it. Seemed to have a bit of a sticking point. I got everything out here. I removed the pivot shaft, and like in Harleys, the swing arm will just basically pull right out. But this, I don't know if it's like wedged in there or if there's some other procedure I had to get that out. So I got to look at that. Another thing is I wanted to get the chain because I went all the way around this thing, couldn't find a master link. So I was like, well, the sprocket must be behind here. I took the screws out, but there's some sealer on this cover. So I gotta check that out, because there's sealer there, that means there's oil in there. So that could be, you know, dangerous. I do have a manual for this, so I'm gonna have to reference the manual for a bit, because look at how they get the chain out. But there's some stuff out here, so I don't want to start ripping everything off. So I'm gonna go do a little research and I'll come back. All right, I looked through the manual, but then I had figured something out. There was a little thing back here. It was in here like this, with just two screws holding it on, and it's a cover that goes right into where the sprocket is. So just this little cover. Two screws. I took out all these screws for no reason, so I'm gonna put those back, but there you go. So I guess it's time to just walk the chain off that sprocket, and then still gotta figure out how to get this thing out of here, but I think there might be some bushings pressed in, so that could be a bit tricky, so let's keep on going. All right, well, I officially overcomplicated that. So what I did, it was just really dirty. So I took a pry bar and just gently stuck it in here like that, and boom, swing arm popped right out. So it was just caked in there with all kinds of dirt and grime and stuff. So now I'll go in, I'm gonna just pull the swing arm out of the way and then undo the bolts, pop that chain off, and then it'll be pretty far out of the way here, pretty close to figuring out how to get this guy out. So I'll be back. Well, success. Took a bit of persuasion. I just took it all out at once, took the sprocket out, and the chain came out with it. So now we're free on the back end. I think that's what I'm gonna call it for tonight. So in the video, it'll be like a second. For me, it'll be a night. So see you guys when we keep going tomorrow. All right, I'm back. It's a couple days later here. Come back to keep working on getting this thing out. So I think right now I need to pull this oil filter and stuff off, because obviously it'll interfere with the frame. Work on some of these engine mounts. So the engine's gonna come out that side that way. So I gotta, basically while it's up here, I'm going to get some of these engine mounts off and out of the way. So hopefully when it sits down on its side like this, I'll be able to undo that side and pull the frame off. There's also a pretty deep oil pan on these CB750s, the A models. So I might have to get that pulled off when it's on its side, but I'll figure that out. So yeah, let's keep on going. For those who may not have ever messed with an oil filter on one of these, it's basically a housing that sits on the front of the engine here. I just put a little drip pan, but it's housing with a removable filter on the inside. It's just like that. So it's not like some where they have a whole canister that's the filter. So just if you're wondering, that's how that works. And I'm just going to dump all this out to make as little mess as possible. Now we will clear the frame rail on coming out. So I'm just gonna get this out of the way here. Now, the next stuff to tackle will be these engine mounts. So you have one up here, which actually fully detaches because the engine comes out this way. One here, which actually a through bolt and detaches so it can come out this way. And then there's one up here in the front. And I think, well, that's a wrapper. I don't know where that came from. Then you have this one, which I think is a rear. So that I'll have to figure out, because I'm not totally sure. So, alrighty. Well, I think one, two, three, and then four. And then this is not going to be an exact science. Like I said, I'm experimenting. This may not even work. I'm going to take it down a little bit, see if I can horse this off here without giving myself a hernia, and then tipping it down over on its side. So basically this side of the engine will be face down. Then I can come pop the rest of the mounts out of this side. Then hopefully it'll fall through and I can grab that frame and pull it off while I'm still holding the garbage in my hand. All right. So I've taken some of the mounts off. I took this mount off here and this one off here. Some of the bottom ones seem like they go all the way through. So I think I'm gonna now attempt to get this thing off this stand and on its side. So the side that's facing us right now will be face down on the ground, and then we can reassess from there. So I just want to stop in and give an update. This thing is a lot heavier than it looks. And I did manage to scoot it off and get it down on its side here. So, back's a little sore. So going around kind of looking, this is exactly what I wanted because the engine will come out on the other side. But here's the culprit. In the manual, it says you take this oil pan off. And from what I see here with how much that sticks out, that's unavoidable. So, when I pulled it off, I forgot to pull a little drain pan out from under, so that kind of all flopped down with it. And then, other than that, I got to figure out the back mount, which is this one right here. I'm not sure how that goes through and connects, but it's all in time to figure that out. There's a nice chunk of mud in there. Then we got this one, which undoes from the bottom here. But I think first step, maybe I'll get the mounts out first, and then I just don't want to make a giant mess. But I put this mat down here as an absorbent mat. I use it for oil changes and shit, so if stuff spills out, it'll just spill onto the mat and not all over the garage floor. So I don't know how many times I'm going to say so. Now I'm going to keep going here and troubleshooting and undoing more mounts and see if we can loosen this frame up and lift her up and off the engine here. All right, we're at. Got all the body mounts out, or the engine mounts are all over here. Looks like I was right. Can't get this thing out. I'm breathing heavy from tugging on it, but I gotta get this oil pan, I think, out of the way. Because if that comes off, it'll just slide right up. But it just barely doesn't have enough clearance to come off with the oil pan on, which kind of stinks. But, you know, I'll zip that off. I'll make a bit of a mess, but that's why I have it on this towel here. So, zip that off and pull this frame off. So here's where we're at. I took all those bolts out of the oil pan, but as usual, it's stuck because it's 1978 and probably hasn't been off in a very long time. So as you saw, I was taking a dead blow, trying to shock it to see if I could like bust it loose from its seal. And that hasn't working. I'm trying not to pry on it too much because it's aluminum and I don't want to chip it up. So I'm gonna keep working at this and see what I can get. Once I get that off, the frame should come right off. Here we are. She is detached. Motor is all by its lonesome. So what I did to finally get it off is see this little tab right here. It was in a position where you could tap it with a hammer and a chisel, and that's what finally broke the seal on this to pop it off. And as soon as it broke, I just took a screwdriver in there and, you know, take the rest of it out. But a lot of garbage on the screen. This is a pickup screen. I don't know if it's going to focus on that or not. Maybe. But anyways, there's a lot of junk on there. So, oil look definitely looks a little old in here. So before it goes together, I'll clean all this up. I need a new gasket. There's the valve body that runs the automatic transmission, similar to what you have in your car. So, how the 750A works. So now I'm going to probably clean this up, temporarily put it back on, because for me to stand the engine up to do other stuff to it, I don't want to set it on that valve body. And there it is all. Wouldn't say that was the easiest way in the world, and it was heavy as hell, but she's apart one-handed, single-handedly, and I'm probably gonna be very sore tomorrow. But there it is. Thanks for checking it out. Now you've seen the 750 engine can come out by yourself. Just a lot of patience and jiggling and lifting and hernias. It'll come out. Thanks for checking it out. It's FW Garage.